Hello everyone, my dear children. Two parts already been explained to you all. Now we will continue. You see the UN flag, the emblem, and now this is a UN flag you can see here. Okay. After the First World War, immediately the League of Nations was formed in order to establish world peace. But the fact that the World War II occurred meant that the League of Nations was a failure. At the end of the World War II, after the World War II, that means, on 24th October 1945, the United Nations was established with the purpose of peace, security, coexistence in the world, and the headquarter was to be in New York. If you see this picture, 3.3, United Nations headquarters, which is in New York. America's efforts to establish United Nations has already begun from the time it joined the Second World War. The American President Roosevelt made four important announcements regarding freedom while giving this message to the American Congress with the intention of human freedom, peace and security. Freedom of speech and thought, freedom of religion, economic freedom, right to freedom from fear. After that, President Roosevelt and the British Prime Minister Churchill, they prepared an 8-point agreement. While they were on the ship in the Atlantic Ocean, they have prepared 8-point agreement and they were in the ship in Atlantic Ocean, which later came to be known as Atlantic Agreement. Because it was in the Atlantic Ocean, they were in the ship. So it is known as Atlantic Agreement. The agreement included matters like maintaining freedom and sovereignty of every nation, peace, security, social and economic welfare, and disarmament. Disarmament means not to use the weapons. Then the foreign ministers of Britain, America, Russia, and China met in Moscow, the capital of Russia, for world peace, which came to be known as Moscow Declaration. In November 1943, their superpowers held a conference in Tehran. There were 50 nations which prepared the agreement for the United Nations at Washington in the month of September 1944, and immediately after 1 year, on October 24th, 1945, the 51 member nations declared the establishment of United Nations. India was also a part of it. Since then, 24th October is being celebrated as United Nations Day all over the world. At present, there are 193 nations who are the members of the United Nations. Now, we'll see which are the organs of the United Nations. They are General Assembly, Security Council, Economic and Social Council, Trusteeship Council, International Court of Justice, and Secretariat. International Court of Justice is situated in Hague, Netherlands, and all other councils are situated in New York, that is America. Now, we'll see the activities of these organs of the United States. For the first one is General Assembly. The biggest organ of the United Nations is General Assembly. It includes the representatives of all the member nations. Yani 193 jo members hain, wo sare, ye sare. Every nation can send maximum 5 representatives to this. But during election, only 1 vote of each country is counted. It can discuss, advise, suggest, or recommend on any matter related to international relations. It accepts the budget presented by the Secretary General every year, and they also have to allocate the expenditures. They also find the solution for the economic problems of the nations. Alag-alag nations ki kya economic problems? So just now, you know, our Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi has represented in UN. You must have seen in the news. Human rights, disarmament or other international matters. Decisions are taken by two-third majority in general matters. Security Council. This is the most important organ. 3.5 figure you see the General Assembly. See how it is being conducted. So many people, the representatives of different countries, they accommodated here in this. Now Security Council. Security Council, very important, pay attention. This is also one of your answers. There can be short notes will be asked on this. All the organs of the United Nations, you consider it as a short note and answer of any of the questions, so you prepare well for that. This is the most important organ of the United Nations. There are 5 permanent members in this. Who are they? We are not in that. America, Britain, France, Russia and China. And other 10 countries are not permanent members. They are elected on the term of 2 years by the General Assembly. The previous topic what we have, I explained here. This council enjoys tremendous powers in order to maintain international peace and security. They solve all the problems, disputes of the nation peacefully by mediation or by negotiation. When any one permanent member does not vote in support of some important international matter, it cannot be take decision on that. Means if they are not able, they are not ready to accept due to some international matter, then the decision on that will not be taken. This power of the 5 permanent member is called veto or right to deny. They can say no to it. Russia has used this veto power maximum number of times. Now come to the next. Economic and Social Council. This is also called as ECOSOC. The General Assembly appoints of its retiring member for 3 years. This council tries to raise the standard of living of the nations of the world without any bias of religion, caste and region. कोई भी region हो, कोई भी caste हो, कोई भी religion हो, कोई भी country हो. This council tries to raise the standard of living of that particular nation of the world. This council has a sub-councils work all over the world. These are the sub-councils. I am going to read one by one. WHO, you all know that. Works to improve the health of the people of the world. IMF, International Monetary Fund, which establishes financial stability. FAO, Food and Agriculture Organization, which improves the agriculture production, forestry and fisheries and raise the nutrition level. ILO is International Labour Organization. This provides rights and justice to the laborers of the world. UNICEF, United Nations International Children's Emergency Fund. United Nations International Children's Fund, now. Undertakes child welfare activities to improve the health of the children of the world by improving nutritional, food and education. Very important. UNESCO, United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization. This works to improve the cooperation between nations by removing illiteracy. Padhai ke bare mein, raising the standard of the living of the people. Kaise? Through education, by providing them justice, education, science and cultural resources. Besides this, there are sub-councils and regional councils which undertake various activities. This is also one of your answer, 2.2. Now we'll see the next point, Trusteeship Council. There are 5 permanent member nations in this council. The representatives selected by the General Assembly are included here. It oversees matters pertaining no nations that have not acquired independence and are under some previous mandate, also nation defeated in the Second World War, as well as its social economy. They see which matters, you know, there are nations which are not independence. Which are not independence. And also they look into the matter when the nations were defeated in Second World War and they have to face the problems with regard to social, economic and political. So these 3 development is the responsibility of the Trusteeship Council. Then comes the next point, International Court of Justice. This is situated in the city of Hague, Netherlands. There are 15 judges in it who are appointed for 9 years. It solves disputes between nations, gives verdict on international disputes presented before it and gives legal advice. And the last one is Secretariat. The office of the Secretary General of the United Nations is called a Secretariat. The General Assembly appoints the Secretary General for 5 years. And the secretaries, administrators, assistants, translators and experts are also appointed to help the Secretary General. The Secretariat is situated in New York. The United Nations has constantly been making efforts to establish world peace. Yes, their main intention is to look into the matter that all the people living in different parts of the world, living in different countries, must have peace. That is world peace, world unity, and to achieve the dream of universal brotherhood. And also in Sanskrit, it is being said, Vasudev Kutumbakam, Sari Duniya, Hamari Family. So, my dear children, thank you. And please read the lesson properly, one by one. Question answers I will be sending you on WhatsApp. The page numbers will be given on it. You have to note down the answers in your workbook. Sorry, workbooks. In your notebook. Sorry. Thank you.